We continue now at the top of Daf Chav Gimel Amud Beis in Maseches Pesachim. This is Pesachim Daf 23b. We had a machlokas between Rabbi Avo and Chizkiah. Rabbi Avo said anytime the Torah says you can't eat something, it means you can't get benefit either. And Chizkiah said that's not true. It simply means you cannot eat from it. So the Gemara tries to bring a proof that this is actually a machlokas tanoim, because the pasuk by chaylev of nevela, by the fat of a nevela, pasuk goes out of its way to permit something. And there's a machlokas tanoim, what exactly is the Torah permitting when it says l'chol melacha? So the Gemara says, my la b'hokam iflugi, isn't this exactly the machlokas between Rabbi Yossi Aglili and Rabbi Akiva? The Rabbi Yossi Aglili savar, because Rabbi Yossi Aglili holds, lo soch lu mashma bein isra achila bein isra hana. When it says you can't eat it by chel of nevela, it means you can't get benefit either. V'chiyasa kra l'mishari l'nevela b'hana hudasa. And the pasuk has to go out of its way to permit in hana, because Rabbi Yossi Aglili agrees with Rabbi Avo that when it says you can't eat, it implies you can't get benefit. For Rabbi Akiva savar, but Rabbi Akiva holds, isra achila mashma, isra hana lo mashma. The pasuk only implies a prohibition to eat from it. There's no implication that you cannot derive benefit. So therefore, according to Rabbi Akiva, it's already known that you can get benefit. And the pasuk is trying to tell you something about tuma and tara has nothing to do with the prohibition of getting benefit. So the Gemara says, lo, no, that may not be the machlokas between Rabbi Yossi Aglili and Rabbi Akiva. To kuli alma, could be that everybody agrees, lo sochlu mashma bein isra achila bein isra hana. Everybody agrees with Rabbi Avo that when it says in the Torah you can't eat from it, it means you can't get benefit either. And here the machlokas between Rabbi Yossi Aglili and Rabbi Akiva is as follows. Rabbi Yossi Aglili sava, Rabbi Yossi Aglili holds, kishahutra nevela, once nevela was allowed in benefit, because we already know that you can get benefit from nevela itself, so he hutra, it is permitted, but chelba vegida lo hutra, but that doesn't include the chelav of nevela, and it doesn't include the gid hanash, it doesn't include the sciatic nerve of nevela either. Those things were not included in the general heter of hana by nevela. So that's why Rabbi Yossi Aglili says you need the pasuk to allow hana. For Rabbi Akiva, sovereign Rabbi Akiva says no. Kishahutra nevela, when nevela was allowed, you were allowed to get benefit from nevela. Chelba vegido nami hutru. The chelev and the gid of nevela were also allowed. V'chiyitzdarich kro l'tuma v'tara. So the psukim are needed for the dinim related to tuma and tara has nothing to do with the yisr hana. So the Gemara now asks on this explanation. For Rabbi Yossi Aglili, according to Rabbi Yossi Aglili, who holds that min hastam chelev and gid are not mutter b'hana, so eshkechon chelev the shari rachmana b'hana. So here we have a special pasuk that allows chelev b'hana. Elogid name of the asr, but would Rabbi Yossi Aglili say the gid hanasha is prohibited in hana because there's no special pasuk allowing you to derive benefit from the gid hanasha? So the Gemara says, Iboy, same if you want, I could say, Hachinami da'asr, that in fact it's true. Indeed, Rabbi Yossi Aglili holds that the Gid Hanasha is asr b'hana. Iboy, same if you want, I could say another answer. Maisi lo b'kal v'chomer. It could be he learns out that Gid Hanasha is permitted in hana from the following kal v'chomer. Uma chelev sha'onush kares. If chelev, which is a punishment of kares, mutter b'hana, it's mutter to get benefit from it. Gid she'eino onush kares. The Gid, which is no punishment of kares there, lo kal shekein, certainly it should be mutter b'hana. So the Gemara now asks, if there's a kal v'chomer that permits the Gid Hanasha b'hana, what does Rabbi Shimon do with that kal v'chomer? Rabbi Shimon is the Tana who holds that Gid Hanasha is asr b'hana. So for Rabbi Shimon do asr, Rabbi Shimon who says the Gid Hanasha is asr b'hana, Iko lemifrach, you can refute this kal v'chomer as follows. Mal lechelev shekein hutr michlolo etzal chaya. When it comes to chelev, it's only the chelev of a behema that's problematic, but chelev of chaya is actually permitted. So tomar begid, but let's look at gid, shlo hutr michlolo etzal chaya. It's not permitted by a chaya, so therefore the gid hanasha does have a stringency over chelev, so maybe it has another stringency that it's prohibited b'hana. V'idach, and the other one will respond to Rabbi Shimon, b'vehema k'amrinan, we're only dealing within behema right now, b'vehema mias lo ishtri. When it comes to behema, chelev doesn't have this leniency, and therefore you can make a kal v'chomer. If chelev is mutter b'hana, for sure the gid hanasha should be mutter b'hana. So the Gemara now summarizes the entire discussion revolving around the machlokas between Chizkiah and Rabbi Avo, and the Gemara says, michli, let us see. Osvinu kol hanikroi. We asked all these questions on Rabbi Avo, all these examples of cases where it says you can't eat something, and it means you only can't eat, but you're allowed to get hana. Vishanino, and we always had an answer, there's some special pasuk that allows you to get hana. So it ends up that in this particular case, in that particular case, Rabbi Avo allows hana. So Chizkiah of Rabbi Avo, but my pligi. So what are Chizkiah and Rabbi Avo even arguing about? Because every single case, Rabbi Avo always had an answer for. So the Gemara answers, b'chametz b'pesach v'aliva d'rabbanan. They're arguing by chametz on Pesach according to the Rabbanan that chametz on Pesach is prohibited b'hanah. B'shor haniskol v'aliva d'divrei hakol. And also when it comes to shor haniskol, that also if you have an ox which gores and kills a human and it needs to be stoned, that also is going to be prohibited b'hanah. And the Gemara explains, Chizkiyah nafik le milo yeyachel. Chizkiyah understands both of these cases are prohibited behanah from the fact that it says yeyachel. It doesn't say yochel, it says yeyachel. For Rabbi Avo, nafik le mi nevela. And Rabbi Avo learns it out from nevela. In other words, the fact that by nevela, Pasuk has to go out of its way to permit it behanah shows you that in these cases, it's prohibited behanah. But the Gemara still says, Michli, let us see. Bein lamaru vein lamar asurin behanah. Both according to Rabbi Avo and according to Chizkiyah, Chametz on Pesach, Shor HaNiskol, they're both prohibited b'hanah. So my b'nai, so still, what's the practical difference between Chizkiyah and Rabbi Avo? It seems like just a theoretical machlokas. So the Gemara says, Ika b'nai, there is a difference between them, Chulin Shenishchetu ba'azara, with reference to, let's say you have Chulin, let's say you have something that's not a carbon, but it was shechted in the Azara, it's shechted in the area of the Beis HaMikdash. Chizkiyah Savar, Chizkiyah holds, Lo Yeyachel Lemu'utehani, the word Lo Yeyachel says you can't get benefit in these couple cases we just brought, Chametz b'Pesach and Shor HaNiskol. And Oso, when it says Oso by Trefa, it says by a Trefa you're allowed to get benefit, like Helef Tashlichun Oso, you can get benefit from a Trefa, Lemu'ute Chulin Shenishchetu Ba'azara. But the word Oso says you're not allowed to get benefit from Chulin Shenishchetu Ba'azara. And Rabbi Avo, Savar, Rabbi Avo says no, Oso Lemu'utehani. Actually, we use Oso to say that here, in this case of Trefa, you can get benefit, but all other cases, or really in this particular example, Chametz on Pesach and Shor HaNiskol, over there, you're not allowed to get benefit. And so therefore, according to Rabbi Avo, you don't have that extra Oso. So Chulin Shenishchetu Ba'azara Lav Doraisa Ninu. So according to Rabbi Avo, Chulin Shenishchetu Ba'azara is not going to be Doraisa. It's not an Isra Doraisa to get benefit from Chulin Shenishchetu Ba'azara. And the Gemara continues, Yosef Ahume Rabbonon Kame de Rabbi Shmuel Bar Nachmeni. One of the Rabbonon was sitting in front of Rabbi Shmuel Bar Nachmeni. V'Yosef V'Kamar, he was sitting and was saying as follows, Mishmei de Rabbi Yoshua Ben Levi, in the name of Rabbi Yoshua Ben Levi. Minayin l'chol isurin shebat Torah. How do we know that by all prohibitions in the Torah, where the Torah says you can't eat something, t'chihechi da asurin ba'achila, that just like they're asur in eating them, hachinami asurin ba'anah, so too they're asur to get benefit. Umay niyu, what examples are we talking about? Chametz b'pesach v'shor haniskol. How do we know that chametz on Pesach and shor haniskol, how do we know they're prohibited in hanah? So the Gemara says, minayin, from where do we know it? Typically, mi lo yeyachel. We already had source number one was yeyachel. So the word yeyachel means you can't get benefit either. So the Gemara says to that, no, lo yeyachel isra achila mashmale isra hana lo mashmale. To him, he understood lo yeyachel means you can't eat, but that doesn't necessarily mean you can't get benefit, so he was not satisfied with that source. So the Gemara tries source number two. Tepuk lemi nevela. Why not learn out from nevela? From the fact that by nevela, the Torah goes out of its way to permit it b'hanah. That says that in these cases, it's asur b'hanah. So for that, he says, no, savar lo, Rabbi Yehuda, because he held like Rabbi Yehuda, diyamar dvarim kichsavan. He says that by nevela, when it says nevela, doesn't mean nevela is permitted b'hanah. It means only very specific hanah is permitted, meaning you're allowed to sell it to a non-Jew, or you're allowed to give it to a ger toshev. That was Rabbi Yehuda's opinion earlier. So the Gemara says, fine, he savar lo k'Rabbi Yehuda, if he holds like Rabbi Yehuda, tepukli mehecha d'nafka le'le Rabbi Yehuda. Let's learn it out from the source we brought earlier according to Rabbi Yehuda. What was that source? It was trefa, mila kelev tashlichon oso. By trefa, the Torah goes out of its way to permit it b'hanah, implying that in these cases it's asur b'hanah. So for that, the Gemara says, no, kasavar, because he happens to hold, chulin shenishchetu ba'azara d'oraisa, that when it comes to the prohibition of getting benefit from chulin, non-korbonos that are shechted in the azara, that's d'oraisa learned from oso, it's learned from lakelev tashlichon oso, that only trefa is prohibited, is permitted b'hanah, but this chulin shenishchetu ba'azara is prohibited in hanah. So therefore, minayin, that's why he's asking for a source, because he eliminates all the other sources. So the Gemara tries a source from Karban Chatas. Tichsiv, because the Pasuk says by Karban Chatas, Kol Chatas asher yuva midama. It says any Chatas where the blood is brought into the Beis HaMikdash, and then it says it has to be burned. She'ein tam v'lomar b'esh tisar, if the Pasuk doesn't need to say that it has to be burned, Uma tam v'lomar b'esh tisar, if what does it have to say b'esh tisar for? Imeinu inyan l'guf, if you don't need it for itself, because the Pasuk already says somewhere else that it needs to be burned. Tineyu inyan l'chal isurin Shabbat Torah. You can use this pasuk for other isurin. Rashi over here explains. Kol chatas asher yuva midam alav b'chatos hapnimios shehuva daman kemitzvosan lifnim ksiv. We're not talking here about what we call the inner carbon chatoses, where the blood is supposed to be sprinkled inside the Beis HaMikdash. We're not talking about that. To habehed yaksiv bohen b'par kohen Mashiach v'helem davar. By those kind of carbon chatoses, for example, the power of the kohen Mashiach or the power helem davar shel tzibor, shreifasun michutz l'machaneh. It already says you need to burn those outside of the camp. So we're not talking about that carbon chatos. This pasuk is talking about the carbon chatos which was sprinkled on the mizbeach outside of the heichal. Dim hichnis doma lifnim psula. It says by the chatos hachitzona that if you bring the blood into the heichal, then it's going to be pasul, and it says you need to burn it. And the Gemara already said, "Emeinu inyan legufo daksiv v'nei sorif." You don't need to say burn it. It already says that you have to burn it. B'seir Nachshon, by the seir that was brought by Nachshon, it says, "B'vayhi b'yom hashmini," in Parsha Shmini, it says, "V'kamer lu Moshe lama sarafta mosa hein lohuvo es dam el hakodesh penima." Moshe Rabbeinu says, "Why'd you burn it? But they didn't bring the blood inside, so you don't need to burn it." Michlal dim huva, that implies that if it was brought inside, shapir avid desarfu, then it's appropriate to burn such a thing. Alma basrefi, so you already see from vihine so rough, you already see that it needs to be burned. So if it already says that, what do we need to say it again for? So the Gemara says, l'chol isurin, it must be to apply it to other isurin, shenemar bohen la b'achilosim kazeh, where it says a prohibition to eat it, v'al karchach lo maisi ala b'chometz b'pesach, v'shor haniskol. Obviously, it's only by chometz b'pesach, and shor haniskol de v'shar isurim k'sib prata l'ater. As we've already said in the last few daf, by other isurim, there's already a special pasuk allowing it. So by chometz b'pesach and shor haniskol, we're going to use this pasuk of Bo'esh Tisarif to say that it's prohibited in Hanah. We'll continue with this discussion in the next video on Daf Chav Dalet Amud Aleph.